Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Techie Tuesdays. I'm your host S. Ravi Kumar. Techie Tuesdays is a weekly show where I answer your tech and career related queries. So if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends, family and colleagues. Now let's get started with today's questions. Today's first question is by Ryan Chang. He's asking, should I learn ASP.NET or ASP.NET Core first when it comes to job opportunities? Ryan, my opinion would be to start with ASP.NET Core because it is the latest version. You can also start with ASP.NET with .NET 5 or ASP.NET Core, whichever is the easier for you. But you should start with ASP.NET Core now because .NET Core is kind of the long-time support version, and right now you will of course get more and more job opportunities in .NET Core itself. So if you learn ASP.NET Core, you can very easily secure a job of a backend developer or a web services developer or probably a NuGet package developer. Any of these jobs you can get if you do ASP.NET Core first. So in my opinion, you should go with ASP.NET Core. However, it is good only if you are already good in C sharp. So if you have prior knowledge of C sharp and .NET Core, then only it is suitable to learn ASP.NET Core first. Because if you don't know anything about .NET Core, the core concepts of .NET Core, how does it works, etc., etc., then there is no fun, or rather fun, you won't even be able to understand how ASP.NET Core works. So in my opinion, you should first learn .NET Core, .NET Core concepts, how does it works, how does .NET Core and C sharp works together, how you can write web APIs using C sharp and .NET Core, because there is very less ASP.NET Core involved in learning C sharp. First you need to understand and learn about C sharp, .NET Core, and then you have to learn ASP.NET Core. So when you already have the knowledge of C sharp and .NET Core, then of course out of ASP.NET and ASP.NET Core, you should go with ASP.NET Core. But if you are completely new or if you are a fresher, then you should first learn C sharp, then learn .NET Core, like C sharp with .NET Core, and then you should learn ASP.NET Core to create web applications, web services, or all those kind of applications. So the brief answer to your question would be that start with C sharp, .NET Core and ASP.NET Core if you are a fresher. But if you are if you have prior knowledge of C sharp and .NET Core, then go with ASP.NET Core. Next question is from Ujjwal Jain. He's asking, what is the difference between product based, outsourcing and service based companies? Ujjwal, let me explain you in simple terms. Product-based companies are those companies which provide a product or a solution. Those products are not always hardware products. Most of the when we talk about product-based companies, we talk about those companies which provides software as a service or a software application as a product. So for example, I would say Google will be a product-based company or productized service based company. So it gives you productized service, be it Gmail or be it Google Mail or be it Google Office, something like that. So that is your productized service. And again, if you talk about pure product based companies, Adobe is also a product based company which has various products like Adobe Premiere Pro, Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator. So these are all products. So basically, a company which works on only one software or one kind of product and they sell it as their own product, be it in a SaaS format, like software as a service format, where you charge like you pay them monthly for that service, or be it as a offline product, like you install it and pay them one time fee. For example, like if you are talking about application video editing software, like Filmora is there, Camtasia is there, where you are paying 20,000, 10,000 rupees for one license, and that license will stick with you for the whole lifetime. So you can use it till complete lifetime and they will give you 1 year or 2 years of update. So that kind of thing. So product based company is a company which create these kind of products, software products. That is a product-based company. So a company which give you a product, be it as software as a service or be it as a license-based product, that is a product-based company. Outsourcing is when you are using the services of a service-based company. In simple words, I would say. Let me explain the service-based company first, then I will explain outsourcing again. But service-based company is a company which provide you services related to software development or any kind of service. So they are not working on a particular product or they are not selling their own product, but they are giving you services in developing any kind of product. So for example, if Google is working on a platform, it is developing a platform, but it's not like that Google always do it completely all by themselves. They hire some other company also as a contractor or developer from some other companies as a contractor to work with them, because it become it is kind of cheaper for them, or it is they get good resources from other companies. So that way, they are basically, what they are doing is they are hiring a service based company. Or another way is when service based company is providing any kind of service. So be it software development, be it estimation, be it testing services. So service-based companies provide various kind of services to the other companies. It not necessarily just a product-based company. It can be any company. For example, I would say that Cafe Coffee Day. So Cafe Coffee Day have their own software. So the company which is developing that software for Cafe Coffee Day, like billing and all the other things, that company is basically a service-based company because it is just selling their service of software development to Cafe Coffee Day. The whole license of that particular software remains with Cafe Coffee Day, but the development is done by the service-based company. Another example is if you want to get your website developed, and if you hire a company which develop that website for you, that is basically a service-based company. In real world, you are saying that a service-based person is like your plumber, your electrician. Those are all service people. So they are providing you a service. So that is basically a service-based company. So when a company like Uber comes up, it's basically a service-based company because it is providing a service to the person. So, but again, that is a productized service. So there is another thing called productized service where you are selling a service as a product. So Uber is basically a productized service, but in general, service is like when you are providing some kind of service-based companies are basically those companies which provide software development or any kind of IT related services, be it network management. So there are companies who are expert in managing large network, managing data centers. So there are these service-based companies. Then there are testing service-based companies which provide complete testing solution, be it stress testing, be it load testing, be it integration testing, all those kind of testing services which are not done by developer. Those kind of testing services are provided by testing service-based testing companies. So these kind of things are basically service-based companies, and product-based companies I have already explained. Now come to outsourcing. Outsourcing is basically a concept. It's not a company type. When you are giving the work to some other company, so usually outsourcing is used by US or Europe-based companies to get job done in India. So because in India the labor is pretty cheap, so that's the reason most of the companies, what they do, that they outsource their work to Indian IT companies. That's how most of the Indian IT companies or service-based Indian IT companies work. They have clients in US and Europe. Whatever application or whatever software they are developing, the developers are basically the Indian developers who are working on, I would say, one third or one half of the price of their US developer. So outsourcing is when you are giving work to somebody else, when you are developing something, but you are giving that work to somebody else, that is basically outsourcing. Next question is from Raghav Goyal. He's asking, which is better for a 1-year dropout, a data analyst or an iOS developer. Raghav, the best is to join back your engineering or whatever program you are doing and complete your degree. Not any one of these. Because without a degree, you will not get a job. Let's be very frank and realistic here. So if you are looking for a job, in my opinion, you should first finish your degree program, be it your BTech degree, whatever degree you are doing. I don't know what degree you are doing. So complete your degree program. Or if you are not doing a IT related degree, join an IT related degree. So finish your degree first, then think about be it data analyst or an iOS developer, because you won't get a job without a degree in India, period. That's it. That's clear. It's a whole big myth that without a degree, without a college degree, you will get a job. I have told this hundreds of times to many people on this platform and every platform, wherever I talk, I say that finish your degree first. In India, you can't get a job without a degree. If you get a job without a degree, that would be, you will be very underpaid. You will not get promotions on time. You will not get proper raises. Switching jobs will be tough for you. So finish your degree first. That is the main requirement. Then after that, choose these things, whether you want to become a data analyst or whether you want to become an iOS developer. So that's the reason I picked your answer. I'm not going to tell you whether which one of these is good, be it data analyst or be it iOS developer. First, finish your degree. Next question is from Ayush Mehra. He's asking, can a person work at freelance even if he is a permanent employee at some company? Ayush, legally, no. If someone is working as a permanent employee of any company, he can't work as a freelancer. So legally, if someone is working in a company, he can't work as a freelancer. As simple as that. However, you need to check with your company's HR. So if your company policy says that you can work as a freelancer, then of course you can work. But in 90% of Indian IT companies, it's illegal to work as a freelancer if you are working with some company. So legally, you can't work. But many people are nowadays, since many people are working from home and many people who are working on some kind of, you can say that, low stress projects where they have less stress jobs, they have some extra time. So they are using that time in working on freelance kind of side projects. They are asking friends to give them freelance jobs, or they are working or doing on freelance side. But that is risky. If your company HR finds out, or if their company HR finds out about that, they can fire them also if it is not legalized in their employment document. So I would suggest better talk with your HR first, get it approved from your HR, and then work on freelance. However, in my opinion, you shouldn't work as a freelancer. If you have a permanent job, then rather than working as a freelancer, you should focus more on building your brand. If you have time, better learn new technologies, blog about those technologies, create videos about those technologies, talk in conferences about those technologies, attend events, share your knowledge. So that way, create your brand or contribute to the open source projects of that particular technology. So basically, spend time in building your brand. So tomorrow, when you are changing the job, you can get the value of your personal brand rather than just the brand name of the company in which you are working. So that is one thing I can suggest. Another thing I can suggest you is, like, if you want to earn income, look for passive sources of income. So something which is not related to your job. So something, some kind of expertise which is not related to your job. Don't look for freelance gigs. Like if you are a designer working in a company, don't look for freelance designing jobs. Rather than create a portfolio on Dribbble or something where you can showcase your design skills, so that people know that, okay, you are a good designer. That way, apart from your company design, you can also showcase your other designs. If you are a programmer, you can contribute to open source. So those kind of things you can do. Now, talking about passive source of incomes, I think that would be investment related things. For that, you need to talk to your CA that how much money you are saving and how you can invest those money to get passive income from stocks, debits, like those all financial things. From there, you can earn some passive income, be it fixed deposit interest or be it stocks or be it something like that, DMAT accounts or SIPs, so those kind of things. So if you are, I don't know your age, you haven't mentioned about that thing, so probably start earning from passive sources of income or start investing in getting some passive sources of income. So that you can also build by writing blogs or by creating videos or like course videos, or once you do the community videos, you will create your own brand of expertise in that particular expertise, and then probably you can create courses and all those things which can be a passive source of income, and they won't be counted as a freelance job because you can get approval from your company that okay, I give sessions in community and somebody has approached me to create a course on this thing, and I won't be using my company resources or I won't be using anything related to my company in this thing. So your company will happily approve that thing, and from there probably you can earn more and you will build your brand also, rather than doing some freelance job for someone in an illegal manner, in a shady manner, and risk your job. Next question is from Abhinav Kumar. He's asking, do I better outsource the coding part of my business or learn it myself? Abhinav, frankly speaking, you are not a true businessman if you learn coding for developing your business or for developing your product, business product. So in my opinion, you should outsource the coding part of your business, and you should focus on growing that business rather than learning coding yourself. Because like from your course question itself, I can understand you are not a seasoned programmer. So if you are not a seasoned programmer, you won't be able to develop a good quality product of your business. So in my opinion, you should outsource your coding part of the business to some experts like me, of course, or you can find someone else over the internet. You can find like freelance developers, or you can find architects who can guide you better in how to develop your business application. But in my opinion, you should outsource it rather than learning yourself to develop that business. But it again comes with the caveat that do you have money or funding to support them or to pay them? If you have money, then of course go with outsourcing. If you don't have money, then you can still go with equity, or you can go with partnership with a technical, you can find a technical co-founder who can develop your application or code your application with some kind of equity and some kind of partnership and slight bit lesser money. So you can go through all that shenanigans. I don't know all the things about the startup world, how you divide those things, profits and all, equities and everything. But frankly speaking, if you don't know programming and you are a businessman, you should focus on your business rather than learning programming. You should outsource your coding part of the business to somebody and who is an expert in development or who is an expert programmer, and you should focus on increasing your business. That way, of course, you will build a team also. Next question is from Bhavya Raheja. He's asking, how do I make a programmer crew or friends online? Bhavya, you need to join the community to do this thing. So the best way to make programmers crew or make friends, programmer friends online, is to join the community of the programming language in which you are working. So if you are a .NET developer, you can join my community, NCR, .NET Cloud and Core Techies, or there is .NET NCR .NET Developers group. Then there is Geeks Meetup group in which I speak regularly. Then there is C Sharp Corner, programming community. So you can join all these communities and then there you can participate in their regular activities. That is one thing. Like you can go there, ask questions if the topic is related to you. You will of course learn something new by attending events, online events of these communities. So by joining online events, online conferences, you can make more and more friends online. Another way is by joining the Slack channel of any community. You can join the Discord channel, Slack channel of any community, be of any framework. So these are the ways using which you can create friends. I have found many foreigner friends of my technology, that is .NET Blazor, via these communities itself. Like I promote one UI framework called Blazorize, and I know the creator of Blazorize personally. He's very good person. He helped me out whenever I face a problem. And apart from not only him, all the other people also who have created some kind of controls, they have their own groups, be it Gitter groups, be it Slack groups, Slack channels, or be it Discord channels. So you can join all these groups and communities, take part in the discussions, and from there you can grow your friendship. So that's the only way I would say. And friendship is not like something which grows overnight. It takes time to grow. So better start joining these communities. Like in my opinion, take out some time, maybe 1 hour daily or half an hour daily, to join these chats and respond to people there. Talk to them about your problems you are facing, or help them out in their problems. If they are facing some problem, you know their answer, then help them out. So that way you can grow your friendship, or you can get a name there in the community that, okay, this person knows about this thing and he can help them out. So I think this is the best way to make a programming crew or friends online, by supporting the community, by being a part of the community. So these were my answers to your tech and career related queries in this episode of Techie Tuesdays. If you want your questions to be answered in next episode of Techie Tuesdays, you can DM me your questions with hashtag Techie Tuesdays on any social media platform. All my social media handles are Techie Rathore. I hope you like my answers. And if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your friends, family, and colleagues. So until my next video, take care. Bye-bye.